The carbon cycle represents the movement of carbon through land, water, air, and all living things. In wetlands, the amount of carbon exchanged between vegetation, water, soil, and the atmosphere over a specific amount of time is called a wetland carbon flux. Wetland ecosystems capture sunlight, water, and carbon dioxide from the atmosphere to create energy to perform photosynthesis, resulting in not only the growth of plants, but also the sequestering of carbon inside of those growing plants. Scientists refer to these plants and the carbon they store as biomass, which can be incorporated into soil organic deposits as roots, plant litter, or other soil life. Boreal peatlands sequester anywhere from 10 to 80 grams of carbon per square meter per year. This might not sound like much, but consider that they cover 120 million hectares across Canada, and in some cases have been accumulating this carbon for over 10,000 years. It adds up. Carbon can also be naturally lost from wetlands in several ways. First, carbon can be lost to the atmosphere. This happens in two different ways. When soils are not waterlogged and oxygen is available, tiny soil microbes use the oxygen to breathe and then exhale that carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. When soils are waterlogged and oxygen is less available, soil microbes produce methane that is emitted into the atmosphere. Another way carbon is lost from wetlands is when water flows through these systems, dissolved forms of carbon can be exported in and out of the wetland. Lastly, when certain types of wetlands burn during wildfires, particulate carbon or soot can be lost from the ecosystem. Collectively, these carbon fluxes represent the net ecosystem carbon balance. Anything that absorbs more carbon from the atmosphere than it releases is called a carbon sink. Over the last 10,000 years, Canada's peatlands have been effective carbon sinks, which produce a net cooling effect on the atmosphere, lessening the impacts of climate change. However, the scales are tipping as disturbances like drainage, permafrost thaw, wildfires, and nutrient enrichment become more frequent and more severe, leading to massive changes in carbon emissions from peatlands. These disturbances can result in peatlands becoming carbon sources, where they may emit more carbon into the atmosphere than they absorb. By applying conservation measures, sustainable land use practices, and restoring drained or degraded peatland ecosystems across Canada, we can manage these carbon-rich areas so that they remain carbon sinks in the future.